Today we'll be hunting whitetails with Bo Jackson. One of his favorite meals is wild pork chops. So who am I to say no to Bo? I guess it's time to do a little grocery shopping before Bo and I hit the hardwoods. Last week, you may recall that I walked up on a big buck. He's got a doe pinned down just inside the timber. I tried to cut the distance and get the shot, but eventually he ran off right through my shooting lane. Never even gave me a shot. Sydney had a big boy drop in at last light, but sure enough, he spotted her and her cameraman attempting to take his life. So Sydney then crawled up in a tree and shot a big doe. Now, we're back and hunting with my good friend, Bo Jackson.
So he's kind of handicapped on his vision and hearing because of his age.
What'd you say?
Too many open field tackles has... No, actually we're gonna go have some fun tonight. We're heading down to one of the food plots, cut corn. And Bo says he can reach out there and touch him, we'll find out. You ready, buddy?
I'm looking forward to it.
Okay.
I'm not looking forward to the walk.
We no sooner came around the corner, and there she was, a big doe, and she's standing right in front of our tree stand. Bo's got a great idea. He's using the "I really don't see you standing there" approach. He assumes that if he walks directly at her nonchalantly, she'll just keep watching until he's in bow range. Yep, good thing I've got some pork chops on the smoker. It's that time of the year that whitetail hunters love, the rut. And the covert trail camera is thumping away tonight. It's important to support hunting all together. Now more than ever, conservation is a must. And hunters contribute more to conservation than anyone else. Nearly $15 billion. So next time you see a wild turkey, a duck flying by, maybe Big Louie standing in the woods, thank a hunter. I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master. And I use Morel targets, Carbon Express arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. Advanced taxidermy brings them to life. I use Muzzy for big fish. And wear mossy oak camo. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call, and I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough. you own a blowgun or spear? Well, Slockmaster.com is where they're sold. We've got the best razor darts, blowguns, fishhawks, and spears right here at Slockmaster.com. They're just too much fun. Pick off a squirrel or rabbit while you're waiting on a deer, and bring home some hossam pepper for dinner. By golly, at Slockmaster.com, we sell the perfect gift. So check us out at Slockmaster.com.
I'm having the time of my life. Give me a blowgun and send me in the woods, and I'm as happy as a little kid in a candy store.
Bo has spotted a buck on a distant ridge. Little does he know that there's more deer and they're moving in behind him. Trouble is, they're about to blow the alarm. There's four does in all, and they've got us spotted, but haven't made a run for it yet. Hopefully Bo can get a shot. Just missed, Bo.
Shot right between her legs. I shot right between her legs. I saw the arrow go. She was at 40, but I knew it was uphill, so I put it at 41. I should have put it at 45, and I would have just center punched her.
That doe's been blowing at us for 20 minutes.
Trapping season runs during deer season, and when I'm on the road, a lot of times I like to take my traps with me. Gives me something fun to do in the middle of the day when I'm not hunting. And it's always good for the environment to take a few predators out.
So when it's really cold out, you're good to leave your animal in the trap after you kill him, only in certain aspects of trapping would I do that, and here's pretty much the only time I do it. That we caught a double, all right? Got a big old coon and a giant polecat. You can see he's dead right by the squeaker. This squeaker's still running too, and this is day 14. That's pretty good. Usually they'll last 10, 12 days squeaking. Enough time to catch a lot of animals. But what a unique set. I had a double set for coyotes here. Caught a raccoon and a skunk in the same set. I don't know how many of you guys out there have done that, but that's pretty amazing. Now, if you can stand the smell of a skunk, he has the most beautiful fur there is. And luckily, I have a friend that is a rotten bastard that'll skin anything. So that's who's getting that one. All right, man. Trapping is, you have to have a passion for it, because as you know, fur prices are tanked out. And you're liable to wear a fur coat down through New York City, and some crazy nut will come up and throw red paint on you. You never know, idiots in this world. But here in Fulton County, you can wear whatever you want, you'll be all right. But not too many fur buyers left, so
anyway, we're going to take care of these hides. It's the right thing to do. And if you love to trap, you owe it to the animals you catch to take care of their fur. So in the meantime, we're reducing the predator numbers and helping the rabbits, quail, and everything else. Lord knows that Steve isn't any good at it, because I just have him hold the camera because he can't catch nothing. Ain't that right, Steve?
That's right.
All right, so here's the ideal setup here. You see there's been a little bit of dozer work right here. And so there's real distinct tracks in the soil. There's a coyote print over here. He's been through here a couple times. So he's hunting this grass and stuff in here for rabbits. And every coyote, he can't pass up a brush pile. So if you see a brush pile where there's been some excavation or, you know, for whatever reason, a deadfall, the coyote will come over and check it out. Well, traditional trap sets, he may miss it. You know, he may see your dirt hole, or he may miss it completely. But with my call, he won't miss it because he can hear this thing 45, 50 feet away. So hold the button down. And it's fairly audible to a human ear, but the coyote, they don't stand a chance. They can hear it too well, as will a bobcat. I got a stick coming out here like this. So it's gonna funnel him into the area where he hears it coming from. You just set it like wherever you want to channel him in. I hide the call a little bit, you know. You don't want to hide it too much. Just enough that he can't get a real good look to see that, oh, that's square, that's man-made, you know. By the time he figures it out, most of the time anyway, he's trapped. So, all right. So I'm gonna cover this trap up, and we're gonna set the camera up on the brush, so Sean will set that up for me and point it towards the trap, and hopefully the plan works. The next day, I checked the trail camera, and a big old bobcat was standing right on top of my trap. He's looking in the brush at the call. Something's gone wrong. And what the heck? Then a coyote came in and did the same thing. I finally figured it out. I had put wet dirt over my trap. I was being lazy and never gathered dry dirt, and sure enough, it got cold that night and froze my trap down. But now the coyote continues to look for the call, and eventually he drags it out and plays with it. That call works good, but if you use it, make sure you use dry dirt in your set. He continued to play with the call, and eventually carried it away. So I lost my call, but you can see that if I'd have used dry dirt, I would have easily caught this coyote. You can reach out to Clint, Sydney, or I on Instagram, or go to slockmaster.com. There you can find us on Instagram, Facebook, or watch all our YouTube videos. We even got some cool merchandise, especially if you'd like a spear or blowgun. Meanwhile, we'll look for you in the timber. So after checking my traps, Bo and I decided to do some more deer hunting. And now we're in one of my favorite stands. Last year, you may recall that Sydney had a buck called Six Pack. He came right in below her stand. Looked up at her and took off. How he got away with that, I'll never know.
Don't move.
Why is this happening?
behind me.
And it's in this very same place that I killed a deer called Sidekick. Man, that's a deer I'll never forget.
Big body. He's a beautiful 5-year-old. Man. They just don't get any better. Chocolate horns. Lots of points. Ooh, looky there. Split ear. He's been fighting. Wow.
So today, I'm back with Bo, and his luck is already starting to change. Bo moves like a cat, so these deer will never see us. Whoops. Bo's hoping the doe will look away, but she's locked onto him with ears and eyes. She's ready to run, Bo. You better take the shot. There she goes. You'll never hit her now, Bo.
Hey, Scorpel. Bo put the arrow to the mark.
Lucky, that was a lucky shot. Lucky shot.
I'll agree with that part. Well, package delivered. Big doe down. Tonight, we're going after a buck.
Are you going to dress her right here along the path?
Yeah, I won't be back in here much more this year.
We'll leave the guts out here for the coyotes. Take the meat back to try to strengthen Bo's body, give him more nourishment because he's looking kind of fragile and weak.
I need the protein. COVID has cost me about 3 or 4 ounces, so I need the protein.
Are you kidding me?
That might not make the edit.